what it's worth, I've been advising a lot of companies across different sectors of society, hospitals, law enforcement, the prisons, and commercial organizations. And I think one of the most challenging here is to think about what we're going to do with schools and daycares. I think any notion that we're going to restart the economy at some point when the time is right will require that we get this part exactly right. Mm-hmm. So there are some things you could do. First, you should be thinking about if your building has been closed or low occupancy for a long time, there are things you have to do before you get back into that space in terms of commissioning or recommissioning your air handling systems to be sure they're functioning properly if they've been turned off or really operating at a reduced capacity. Second, you have to think of things that are unrelated to COVID-19. And here I'm thinking about water quality. Really in low occupancy buildings, these are perfect conditions for stagnating water that promote bacterial growth. And I'm thinking of bacteria like Legionella that can cause Legionnaire's disease. So you also have to recommission your system there and do the appropriate flush outs. As you start to repopulate again, when the time is right, you have to have a plan in place that has these multiple control levels, including enhanced cleaning and disinfection protocols, not just which cleaner should we use, but also what's the frequency? Which surfaces should we be cleaning? What are the appropriate personal protective equipment the cleaners need to be wearing? Do they have the proper training? And on the building side, yes, there are some real specific things you want to do. You want to bring in more fresh outdoor air. If you have operable mm-hmm. windows, open them up. Or if you have mechanical system, 100% outdoor air. If you're recirculating some of that air, like many buildings do, you need to increase the filter efficiency of your building. We rate these in terms of what are called MERV rated filters. You want to get to a MERV 13 or higher. If your building can't do these things, and there's a physical limit to what it can do, you could also consider the use of portable air purifiers that have HEPA filters and are sized appropriately for the room. So the harder part there is the administrative control side. So how are you going to segregate parents and the children so you don't have too many visitors or people coming into the space? And then, of course, how do you protect your workforce and the children at the same time? So we're going to have many enhanced cleaning protocols, but also increased hand washing and the usual.